Hello and welcome to a very awkwardly angled edition of Mark Fixes Stuff. It's a box opening edition, so there's pickups and it's stuff that I've got from Rich Round of Old School Gaming in Briley Hill. Sorry about the awkward camera angle, but it's a big box in a very small space. This is Mark Fixes Stuff. Okay, so let's start sliding the knife. The knife is a proper knife as well, look. Not even rusty screwdriver. Into the box. Now, there's always surprises when it comes from Mr. Round, so let's see what comedy he has provided us with this time. Now, the first thing I will have to tell you before we open this is that this was from an auction win, which I won for very, very cheap. Because I wouldn't have bid any more. Because this is not the Snowman of Shite from before Christmas. Oh no, this is the Penguin of Pooh. That's right, so Penguin of Pooh. Plus there's another system in here, a vintage 8-bit system, which we will be looking at. So, top box is open. I'm assuming the second box is sealed as well. So here we go. Open the flaps. I might actually have to cut the flap off, believe it or not, because it's in the way of the tripod. I'm in the new man cave, which you've probably seen in the previous video. I'm using some new lights as well. So what have we got here? I'll tell you if it's Penguin of Pooh or not, because I know the other bit. Yeah, slice that off. Anyway, how is everybody? You all right? No, I haven't been around a lot, so... Ah, yes, this is not Penguin of Pooh. This is a system she very kindly let me have for pennies. This is the Philips VideoPak G7000. Would you look at that? Now, the box is a bit tatty, to say the least. In fact, it's almost not there. So, needs a clean, he said, and probably a bit of TLC. So... Philips video computer, although it's got a joystick anyway, and I guess that will be a fire button at some point. But that looks pretty good actually, I think that'll clean up a treat. Hold it so we can get the lights. It's got a plug, so Peter Kay's dad would be happy. Okay, so yes, VideoPak G7000, thank you Richard, looking awesome. We'll have a look at that in an upcoming video. Now I've got my own space for this sort of thing. Lovely, put that to one side over here. And there's the box there. Not a lot going on in there. It's very, very battered. We'll keep it, obviously, bit of history. Not historical bubble wrap though. So that can come out. Now also with the video pack, we have got, you guessed it kids, some games. So we've got VideoPak 4. I don't know what's on any of these, by the way. VideoPak 8. VideoPak 5. VideoPak 2. Something in a package. We'll have a look at in a moment. Cowboys. VideoPak 11. VideoPak 2. Goodness me, these are all just numbers, aren't they? Yeah, Road Racing, one car. Road Racing, word game. I'll pull these out quick. Alien Raiders, Target Shooting, Hidden Submarine. Oh my goodness, there's lots. Golf. Don't know. Video pack. Electronic Billiards. Billiard American. Whew, there's a few. Video pack 20 in a box. The cart in there, or is it loose? No, VideoPak 20, the cart is in there. Sorry, the kind of awkward camera angle is making it difficult for me to... VideoPak 39, Freedom Fighters, looks good. I do like old computers, especially ones with lots and lots of software. Munchkin and Space Monster. Wow. This is a lot of software. Thank you, Richard. I wasn't expecting quite this amount of cartridges. VideoPak 4, Air Sea War. Maybe let's have a look at these in a video. I'm waiting for a shelf to go up in the corner so I can have my 14-inch CRT there. And I've actually got a capture card. VideoPak 14, don't know. Cowboys. They don't seem to say Cowboys on the back. I think there's a few doubles. Video pack 18, Laser War, Gure Laser. Yeah, so good. Philips video pack 33, Jumping Acrobats. That looks pretty fun, actually. That one, Jumping Acrobats. Goodness me, I'm running out of desk space. Video pack 24, Flipper. Looks like an early pinball game type thing. Very nice. And I think there can't be any more. All right, what's this? Thanks for your help with the group with compliments. Oh, I've just recently helped Richard do a couple of bits on his new group, which will be linked below. And this says with compliments. Let's find that knife. Where's the kniff? I've only gone and bloody lost it. In 2 minutes I'll lose anything. Right. Oh, it'll have to be fingers, I'm afraid. Have to be fingers. There we go. That's very exciting. Not expecting this at all. So, Look at this. Would you look at this? Look. Double Dragon 3 and Double Dragon 2, the Revenge. I told Richard that I'd like these, but I hadn't actually paid for my pile yet. Oh, that's so kind, Richard. Thank you very much. Double Dragon 2 and Double Dragon 3 for the NES. Lovely. Do you know, all I'm missing now is an actual NES. I've got quite a few games, but I've not got an NES of my own that... Wow, that is excellent. Thank you. Oh, and Bubble Dizzy as well for the Amstrad. Look, awesome. Rich, that's awesome. Thank you, mate. Brilliant. Oh, wow. Absolutely made up. Thanks. Right, so that's the end of the top box, and there's a box underneath. So I'm going to do a quick jump cut. Jump cut. And 3, 2, 1, rolling. And we're back with the Penguin of Pooh. Yes, I've sliced the box open, and you're literally going to go through the joys and the trials and tribulations, the highs and lows, with me as we go through this box. Oh, shit. Let's see what's in the shit box. Ha-ha! I can hear your excitement as we cut off the flaps, YouTube. There we go. I have no idea what any of this is. But let's see together. Good job, I'm going to the tip, isn't it? Oh, you're not allowed to call it the tip anymore. You have to call it the Waste Recycling Centre. Yeah, all right. Well, I take my stuff and tip it in. Oh, here we go.
Do you know, I actually watch my videos to see the back of my head to see if I'm going bald. Right, so first up, we can see it already. It is Tetris Tower. Hey, boys' toys. Bit sexist, really? But yeah, let's see what we got here. Tetris Tower 3D. The world's most popular game. Really? The world's most popular game? Because I'll be honest, YouTube, I'd never heard of it before. Oh, look, the facial recognition is picking up this overly excited child. Very good. Does it pick him up? No, it's obviously detected him for the corporate drone that he is. Okay, so let's have a look. Touch and feel and control the pieces. I wonder if it's all in there. Might be something to hand the kids. Yeah, looks like it's all there, and it's even got one battery. Look at that. Right, so Penguin of Pooh. What have you pooped out? Well, don't quite know what to make of that. It's very... I think it's like Connect 4, but for Tetris. Okay, so let's get a piece. Pop a piece in there. Wonder if all the pieces are there, probably. I've got to admit, my patience is running thin with this one already. I don't like things like this, but my kids do. It's just like the real thing. You can smell the Game Boy. Yeah. Okay, so moving swiftly on. There's lots of bits in there. Thank you, Penguin of Pooh, for pooping out that pile. Instructions are screwed up, so I hope someone's obviously been a bit pissed off. If enough people, well, if 10 people ask me in the comments to do a video of playing that game. I will, otherwise I won't bother. Okay, so let's remove some of this. Uh-oh. Oh no. It's the Penguin of Pooh, and also some Atari carts which I purchased legitimately. Let's see. Let's see the Atari carts first, actually. Pound a cart, can't be bad. Alright, so I'm just going to pass them up in front of the camera. So, Warlords for the 2600. We've also got Midnight Magic. Oh, David's Midnight Magic, I believe, for the 2600. Also, Super Breakout for the 2600. Phoenix. By the time I get a copy of Phoenix for the 2600, they're all for the 2600, I'm going to stop saying that. Pole Position. Riddle of the Sphinx. Seems legit. Sprint Master! Yay! A few more down here. Hang on. Okay. Let's see what else we've got. We have got Battle Zone. Brilliant game, by the way. We've got Secret Quest. Shh, don't tell anyone. By Nolan Bushnell. It's a secret. We have Solaris. Obviously a game and not the operating system. F-14 Tomcat. Absolute Entertainment. Seems legit. We've got Defender 2. Ooh, that'd be good. And we also have Dark Chambers. Lovely. Brilliant. Thanks for that, Rich. Great deal. Pound a cart. Can't be bad. Get a bit more carts hanging around in there before we go into what I'm lovingly going to call my sack of sheet. Oh, something falling out there above here. It is. Ground Zero Texas. What the hell that is, I don't know. What's it for? The Sony something. I don't know what that is. Sega CD. Oh, it's a Sega CD game. Disc 2. Oh, and Disc 1. That's always handy. For Sega's Mega CD. Excellent. I've got a couple of Mega CDs. Should fix one up and play that, really. Brilliant. Thank you, Rich. Pop that to one side. A Sega RF out switching unit. These have obviously fallen out of the bag. Look at that. Oh, quality. Sega! Okay, and into the bag we go. Do you want to see into the bag, or should I just put my hand in and grab the first turd? Let's go. Now the first thing out is, oh look, it's Atari 2600, little baby one. How are you doing, Junior? I'm fine, Dad. And it belongs to Rachel Glorin? I don't know. It's not hers now, though. It's mine. All mine. It belongs to me. My Atari. Right. So, brilliant. Excellent. I have got a few Ataris, but it's all good. Nothing bad. Next up is an Atari 2600. But get this. Look. Home Alone from Big Magazine. Think big. Well fit, kicking. If you can read this sticker, you're too close. Whoa, mama. Hands off. Spam head. God, this is so 80s. The Jetsons. Football. And the evergreen classic, Gordon the Gopher. Half, half. Wow, that doesn't belong to Rachel Glodwin. Seen better days, actually. It's hanging open. So, yeah, we'll have a look in there. Nothing else, will clean it up. Always good for parts. And, yeah, brilliant. So far, the Penguin has pooped out some good stuff. See what we've got in here now? We've got... Tun, 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 Super Breakout. Atari gift pack. Three cartridges for the price of one. I wonder how many are actually in here. It's one cartridge, and it's Super Breakout. Awesome. I think that might already be in the pile. Yes, it is, yeah. So, got doubles on Super Breakout. Anybody? So, that can go there. Pop that there. Let's see what else we've got here. Oh, you know what? I think we might have found the other cartridges. It's because we've got Yar's Revenge for the 2600. How many times have I said 2600 now?
We've also got
combat. That is actually really good fun. The tank game is brilliant. I mean, all pretty much the same game, just moving in different directions. Okay, there's instructions in there as well. Good lord, look at that. Game program instructions. Whoa. It actually smells like the 80s in here. It smells like Kelly LeBrock's thong. So, what are you little animals going to make me do first? See, I wouldn't have had a problem with that question. But, you know. What's this? Oh! Asteroids! Awesome! And it's there. And the booklet! Yay! Oh, this is awesome stuff. So far, this Penguin of Pooh has turned out to be the Penguin of Fucking Awesome. Right, I think we might be getting into poo territory now, because we have got the Plug and Play classic TV game, Power Joy, which is obviously a rip-off of an N64 controller. Who knows? I'm not sure that's a part of it or not. It's the same shitty plastic. And it's got a DB9 connector. Yeah, it might just be a controller. Who knows? Who cares? Let's put that to one side and see what else is in the box. Power Joy! Dum dum dum! It's a TV game. And it's got a slot. I wonder if it's a Famiclone. If it's a Famiclone, then I will be able to play my NES games on it. It needs a cartridge. Let's see. And four batoirs. So, run a bit out of desk space now. Ah, cartridge is in there. Look at that. Power Joy PJ008. Awesome. Thanks, Rich. Or thanks, Mr. Penguin. Hey, does it list the games at all? No, it just assumes you're going to buy it blind. That classic TV game. Classic TV game. What is it? Freaking Family Fortunes. Who knows? Put that to one side. What else is in the Penguin of Pooh? Oh, PS2 WRC Rally Evolved. Brilliant, let's see if he's in there. I do like a PS2 game, to be honest. Should get my fat sorted out, my PS3 fat. Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, he's a surly old twat. Early in the morning, just when day is dawning, he fiddles with his penis in his van. Stop it, Pat. Pat, stop it. Pat! Oh, you dirty bastard. Postman Pat. No Jess, though, unfortunately. Look! It's a... don't know, actually. I'm not very good on my Pokemon, because I'm a bit too old for all of that. It's an official Nintendo product. Is it Squirrely Pops or Jiggly Pops or something? Jiggly Puffs? I don't know. Very cute. My little girl will like it though. She loves Pokemon. Notice I say Pokemon and not Pokemon, because I'm not an idiot. Right, okay, what else have we got in here? Good lord! It is! Chun chun chun! The Essential Pack! That I've never had before, so my life has been empty. It's for charging your DS's and stuffs. It's a DS case, nice, that'll go with the DS I've got up there. And bits and bobs like headphones and... Oh, you're all getting a bit bored there. Cases. strap thing. Yeah, pretty much like you pick up off a market stall. Excellent, thanks for shiting that out, Mr. Penguin of Pooh. Over there. Still loads of stuff, guys. Okay, I'm gonna leave that bit there. Oh my goodness. Ah, now we are getting to some shite, I'm afraid. Here we go. Football game on the Xbox original. Ghost Recon Island Thunder. That actually might be worth a play, actually. I'm gonna assume there's discs in here. Rainbow Six 3. I like Rainbow Six 3, Rainbow Six games, so I might give that a whirl. Max Payne. You wag Richie. Pro Evolution Soccer 5. Buffy the Vampire Sexy Bear. Ooh. Facial recognition. Oh yeah. Right, hit pause and fap now, guys. No, actually, fap now, guys. Oh, there's not much there. Fap now, guys. What's that hand doing? I don't care. Move on.
What else have we got? More soccer, no doubt. Right, so here we go.
Yes, FIFA Street. Yeah. Halo 2. Interesting. Pro Evo Soccer 5. I think I've got one of those already, haven't I? And FIFA 2005. Never going in my machine ever. Right, FIFA.
Let's see. We're nearly there, guys. Hold on. It's all over by the shouting. Masturbating. There we go. All this stuff is.
The Penguin of Pooh's face. And, actually, I'm going to just. There we go. Penguin of Pooh's face. That's better. And we have got for the Wii, Dave Mirror BMX Challenge. Scratch the fuck. We have got Wii Fit. Another copy of Bastard Wii Fit. I've got a picture somewhere on the internet of me actually logging into Wii Fit and it's saying, we have not seen you for 700 and something days. Oh, look, an Xbox remote for a 360. That is really good. I like that, yeah. I don't know if it needs a receiver, but yeah, swalky. I've got a 360, I'm going to put in the man cave. And finally, FIFA 2005, to go with my other copies of FIFA 2005. Brilliant. Okay, so that was shit. Let's look at what else there is.
There are a couple, I think two more bits. So,
what's this? Wii Play. Okay, cool. Let's have a look, see if there's anything in it. It's a, no Wiimote, but there is a silicone skin. And I think there is actually a Wii Play game in here. Of course I have Wiimotes. I like Wii Play. Excellent. Well, that's good. That's worth having. Even for the case. The white cases. Oh, not standard issue. And I think finally there is something left in here. Which is a bit weird. I'm not sure. It might be tied together. Right. Here we go. Radica, the name that strikes fear into the hearts of actual gamers everywhere. Because this, my friends, my pedigree chums, is a Mega Drive TV game. Oh, I can't wait. I might make a video of this just so you can see how poxy the sound emulation is on most Mega Drive emulators. And it's Radica as well, so they're bound to have fucked it royally. Brilliant! I'm happy to have it though. Yeah, I'm on it like a tramp's dog on chips. Right, well, I've bored the crap out of you. I've got to clear all this up now before my wife comes and has a look and screams. But thank you for watching. This is Mark from Mark Fixes Stuff signing out and reminding you to subscribe to get your fix.
Stop it. Why are you looking at me like that?
Oh, you know. No reason. No reason at all.